when you're talking to somebody, there are skilled things you can do that lead them down a different path and even make them take completely different actions from these subtle things that you do. How to persuade people to buy from you. Persuasion skills are the highest paid skill on the planet. Think of anybody extremely financially successful, and chances are, if they've done it through business, they are influential. Income, your relationships, how many other people will come to your rescue when you're in need? How many other people will help you get ahead in life? What about the things you're doing as well? If you're better at persuasion, you can persuade the group of people you're with to do the things you want to do. What if you want a partner? You need to sell yourself. But if you're in direct sales, this applies to you more than anything, you know, learning comfortable silence. And you need to just shut up and let them fill those gaps. A lot of people sort of want to feel the silence when they're presenting, because a silence is uncomfortable for both parties. But if you feel it, if you're constantly feeling the silence, you're losing power in the conversation every single time you do it. So the best time to use this is closing a sale, definitely. Once you've closed a sale and you've asked for the close, that's the best time to stay quiet, because they're thinking, they're considering your offer. By you talking, you're giving them an out. Why would you give them an out? You need them to talk because you either want them to say, yeah, let's do this, right? You want them to close themselves. But the other thing is, if they don't close, you need to know why. You know, maybe they're hung up on this certain issue. If you stay silent enough, you're going to hear what it is. Another one is tie-downs. And I mean, tie-downs work, don't they? And that's what a tie-down is. It's just a sentence with a closed yes question at the end. A lot of times, the silence continues, especially when I was selling business to business, because business people kind of know this stuff a little more than consumers, and sometimes they will stay silent. They're not really uncomfortable in a silence. They're used to that. So what I might do is break the silence then. Only after a while, I would leave a lengthy gap, but then I would say, you know what I think, don't you? And the reason I did that was to try and just get where their head was at. And usually often they just say, no, what do you think? And I would not answer that. I would let them answer. I'd say, well, what do you think I think? This is like non-directive therapy. And I'd have a smile on my face. I'd make it playful. It wasn't offensive. And, you know, if it was a strong presentation, good rapport, very often they would just look at me and say, well, Tristan, you want me to buy this, obviously. And I'd say something like, why wouldn't you? And if I would say these things, you're drawing the objection out of them. And then they might say, well, it is pretty pricey. And that's them giving you the objection. And I'll tell you how to handle objections in a second too. But as for tie-downs, I used to also work for Living Social. We do business to business, and we were selling customers to restaurants with empty seats. And that would be another tie-down I would use all the time. They'd say, look, we're busy, we're full. They're full Friday, Saturday, maybe Thursday. But Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, usually a restaurant has at least a 30% idle capacity. So I would always say, okay, so you're full. What days are you full? So Thursday, Friday, Saturday is full? So I'd set up the question for them, so all they had to say was yes, and they'd say yes. And then I'd say, well, what about Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday? I mean, you'd like to fill those seats, wouldn't you? And that was the tie-down. They have to say yes to it, because of course they do. They're not going to say, no, I don't want to fill those seats. There's a million little tie-downs, but it's really sort of script-specific. There's isn't it, doesn't it, wouldn't it, hasn't it, wasn't it, shouldn't it? There's like 1,000 more, but I mean, you get it, don't you?